Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we're looking at center drills and spot drills, looking at the difference between the two and which we should use. I've had some arrive from Banggood and we'll take a look at them. So let's go into the workshop and have a look. These are a set of spot drills sent by Banggood. They go from 12mm down to 3mm. Let's have a look at this one. And the difference between a center drill and a spot drill, if you look at the end, you can see a spot drill just has, well, this one is 120 degree angle, which goes to a point. And the center drill has a diameter and the part that forms the center. Now, you usually use a center drill when you're holding, working the lathe in a center. And that's because this part of the center drill is formed at 60 degrees so that you can use a center in the end and it runs true. Plus, this part clears the point of your center, so you're not going to get any swarf or anything there that's the center's running on. Now, with the spot drill, it's just as it says, comes to a point, and when you use it, it just gives you a spot on your work. You can drill into the material that you're cutting, but not very far. As you can see, the flute on this only goes down about 30mm. So once you've passed 30mm depth, it's going to build up and start causing you problems. So a spot drill is there to give you a start on a drill. It's usually short like this one to give you a bit more accuracy. Now, this one's got some marks on her here. I don't know whether I can see that on the camera. This is a 10mm spot drill. They're all marked up with the size and the material. 10mm, 120 degree point, high speed steel, CO8. CO8 means there is 8% of cobalt in the high speed steel, and it also has titanium coating. These are all sold individually if you want to buy just one size. I'd say on this one you can probably drill down about 20mm before you start blocking the swarf and having a problem. But they're mainly to put a spot on your workpiece. So it's a bit like a center punch, except that you can place that more accurately because it's shorter. And if you're on your milling machine, you can use your table, X and Y, to get your accuracy and position. But this will put you an accurate centre in the right position. Now, talking about centre punches, I found this out the other day. Going off the subject a bit, but this one I made when I was apprentice, so that's 50 years old. And you might look at that and think, well, that's nothing special, you could do that anyway. But when we were given the material and the drawing for it, we were given a piece of round rod and two files and told we have to make a centre punch. And it has to be accurate because each part was marked for accuracy, visual appearance, and that you've got it correctly to the drawing. So we spent probably a day, day and a half making that centre punch. And I always remember that because I was looking at the grinding machine thinking I could do that in 5 minutes in that grinding machine. So the idea behind it was that you learned how to use the tools, how to use files, how to produce an accurate job. So let's go back to the spot drill. You can see now obviously the difference between a spot drill and a centre drill. And you can buy whichever size you need. And they're all made of the same material. Okay, I'll take the 6mm spot drill. Strip out. This is aluminium, so I'd expect it to cope with aluminium easy, but I just wanted to see the form of the hole. I can drill straight through the aluminium because it's thinner than the flutes on the drill. Just take the 6mm reamer, just see how well it fits the hole. That's okay. So I'll see if I can find a piece of steel. This is a piece of mild steel bar with the bar has a black finish on it, so it's not bright drawn. It has some scale on the bar, so that will, we'll see how it copes. No problem with that. I wonder if I can bring it. And if you look, that's slightly offset. Let me cope with that okay. So I'll bring it back onto center. See if I can put a little spot on there. Yeah, so that's done that. So if I wanted to put a cotter pin or something through, I can spot it to give me the centre. I'll try some different steel. Now this is a piece of wrought steel joist, so it's rolled steel. Let's just see how it copes with this. problem. Can I say they do what they're supposed to do? Oh well, that's it. That was a 6mm spot drill. I'll put a link on the front of the video if you're interested. Give you more information about the sizes and the material and the prices. I hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots.